The next time you check out your Facebook page, your profile may look a bit different than it did the last time you checked. But don't worry, it's just Facebook's new look. It's another redesign. This one has a new area for your bio and displays a bar of recent photos in which you've been tagged. You can also highlight your most important friends and activities and interests. All 500 million Facebook users will have the new look by early next year. And joining me to talk about this is BJ Lutz, one of our web guys at NBCChicago.com. So why do this?
A couple of big reasons. One is to enhance the relationships that you already have or make new ones. Second big one is to get you to share more information. And it remains to be seen whether the first part's going to work. It just rolled out. We're a little over 24 hours into the new redesign. But that latter point, people are already sharing more as you go through and manipulate your profile.
Already since this 24 hours?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Friends in my list are telling more about where they went to school, what sort of jobs they've had. You can now connect people that you've either with whom you've had classes or worked with, and all those relationships are, it's the web is of Facebook is really building.
Huh. Now, were people asking for this, or were they complaining about the format before, or was
something
out of whole cloth?
I think most people were happy. I just think this is the next evolution of what Facebook thinks is good for enhancing relationships. And really, what they're trying to do is bring out some of the information that you already had, perhaps buried in your profile, bring that up to the front page more. Supposedly, like if you met somebody out at a club or something, and, you know, how would you introduce yourself? Well, your name, where you work, you know, maybe where you went to school, a few of your interests.
Uh-huh.
All that information is now on your main profile page, and that gets the conversation started.
So before you have to click on accounts or...
Yeah, you'd have to strategically go to the info tab.
So you'd have to have an interest already to go there.
Right.
This way it's out there, which may spark your interest.
Absolutely.
This is kind of like dating again or something. It has that kind of feel to it, just making everybody a little bit...
Yeah,
and it's
kind of neat. I mean, there's one contingent of people that, you know, only use Facebook are the people that they already know. And they're like, well, why would I want to do this?
Right.
But even if you do know somebody, you might see a movie that they liked. And you had no idea that they were a fan of that movie. And it's just all about, you know, enhancing that dialogue.
Oh, that's very, very interesting. Now, is there any evidence that Facebook is losing any of its juice?
No.
No. It's growing.
As you mentioned earlier, 500-some million people.
500 million.
Spending some 700 billion minutes a month on the site.
Wow.
More than half of their users log on every day. Mobile is exploding. No. They're not running out of steam.
In a word, no. What about any competition? Is there anybody out there that's even close or any new? Like Groupon, I kind of heard, you know, I know they're big in the last year, mm-hmm. unless they've been growing in the last 2 years. And they've really grown and sort of become sort of a social media because of the sharing of the coupons and all of that.
Sure. But as a whole, no. I really think Facebook is the juggernaut. You've got those little like buttons all over the web, and it's just there seem to be in every nook and cranny. 60 Minutes did a great profile piece and interview about Facebook last night, and it's just huge.
It ain't going nowhere.
People are even searching on it. You know, would you rather search for something and get ads or links that have been strategically marketed to you, or would you rather get advice and feedback from people that you already know and care about?
Well, there you go. One quick other thing, too, is they're doing a change for a cause, in a sense, at least for now. This thing about people putting cartoons on for instead of their face, their pictures?
Yeah, you originally heard about it first in the middle of November, and it's really taken off in the last week or so. People changed their Facebook profiles to these cartoons, and the idea is you want to see a human face on Facebook until I think it ends sometime tonight, and it's just to bring awareness to
child abuse in this country, which is pretty cool, and it's a way to get people engaged in that. I heard this through somebody else, so it's talking.
And it's viral. You see it on Facebook. You're like, what's that all about? All your friends are doing it, so you do it too.
It's very cool. Thanks so much, BJ. You always help make things clear for me, the novice. Appreciate it.
Sure.